Good morning, one and all. My name is Nagaraju. I am going to teach about the MM subject. In this, we are going to learn about types of fastenings. Types of fastenings. So, basically, we have three types of fastenings. So, we have two types of fastenings. One is permanent joints. Permanent joints. And temporary joints. In the permanent joints, we are able to see the riveted joints, and welded joints. And coming to the temporary joints, the screws and nuts will come to the picture. Screws and nuts. In this class, we are going to discuss about riveted joints, and next class we have discussed about the welded joints. And coming to the riveted joints, what do you mean by rivet first? That we should know. First, we should know rivet. What is mean by rivet? The rivet is nothing but a solid circular body, we call it as a shank, and it has a head, and also it has a tail. This type of arrangements that we call as a rivet. Okay. Whereas head is constant and which is depending upon the nominal diameter d, and this body is also called as a shank, also called as a shank or body. And this is tail. If you observe the figure, the head is constant, which is depending upon the D. And whereas coming to the tail side, we always giving the punch or giving the force to the tail only, with the help of that. Then only the joint will be dextral. This is before joint. So whenever the joint is produced, then your rivet size comes to in this direction. Then your rivet size comes to in this way. And the rivets is also used to produce leak-proof joints. Leak-proof joints. What do you mean by leak-proof joints? The leak-proof means there is no escaping of gases as well as fluids from the plates. Fluids from the plates. Okay, for the leak-proof joints, we are able to use the two methods. One is riveted method as well as welded method. However, we have discussed about the riveted methods. So there is the riveting means it is a leak-proof joint. If this leak is takes place, then what to do? If the leak is takes place, what to do? We have two methods to reduce the leaks. That is caulking, and pulling. These two methods are very, very important for your competitive point of view also. The caulking and fullering, both the process we are using to produce leak-proof joint if there is any leak between the plates or between the rivet heads to plates. So, for example, I have taken as a plates. So, these plates are joined with the help of the rivet. If there any leakage between these two surfaces or these two surfaces, we need to use obviously caulking or fullering. So there is only small difference between caulking and fullering. The caulking means we are using sharp edge tool to produce leak-proof joints. Just wherever the leak is taking place, then we will put the tool and we will hit other tool. Then the joint will be takes place. Perfect joint will be takes place. Whereas coming to the fullering process, however we are using the tool, but the tool size or tool tip thickness will be that is equals to the that of the plate. So that if you hit this plate, there is no damage will be takes place, there is smooth joint will be takes place with the help of this type of fullering tools. Fullering tools. However, whenever we want to produce leak proof joints, the 90% we are going with the fullering process. 90% we are going with the fullering process. Why? Because the tool tip thickness will be equal to that of the plate. If it is equal to that of the plate, what happens? The smooth force will be applied at the for the thickness of the plate, then joints will be takes place. Whenever if you use the culking tool, it is having the sharp edge. Due to sharp edge, if you apply excess force, the plate tearing will be takes place. Due to that reason, we are using the fullering tool. Whereas, so coming to the strength of the rivets. So before that, we know the what is meant by strength. The strength is nothing but ability to absorb or to ability to resist the force. Whereas coming to the rivet sections, we are able to see the three types of strength. One is tearing strength and shearing strength, and next one is crushing strength. So strength is nothing but how we could say the strength it is indicating in terms of stress. Our subject point of view, the strength always concerned in terms of stress. Tearing stress, shearing stress, as well as crushing stress. Also we call it as a tearing strength, shearing strength and crushing strength. Whereas coming to the tearing strength, that means ability to resist the tearing force, that we call as a tearing strength. So what is tearing force? Let us see the figure. I am drawing this figure per pitch length. So before that, what is mean by pitch? It is the difference between center point of view two consecutive rivets. So for example, here to here we call as a pitch length. That is P. The tearing will be takes place between these two rivets or these two holes. So we need to consider only this area. So how can you derive this area formula? So we know that here to here the distances are, and here to here distances are. Now what is this distance? The total is P. Then what is remaining? It is P minus 2R. The 2R represents what? The diameter. So that this will be the P minus B. We know the stress equation, or we know the tearing strength. That will be the tearing strength. The tearing strength is equals to force upon area. Area means it is cross section area. If you see this one, this is projected area. What do you mean by cross section area? Where it is cut, you can see from this front side. Then the thickness will be also be takes place. The tearing thickness we can take as a T. So here the force is tearing force, the PT divided by area. You could see, so from here to here it is my area. However, this is a tearing portion. So which length will be P minus T? The thickness T, and it is look like a rectangle section. The area of the rectangle section will be base into height, that is D into P minus T. Then tearing strength sigma T. From this, the tearing force, the PT, is equals to T into P minus T into sigma T. This is called the strength of the plate at tearing.
and tearing.
Okay, we will stop here. So we'll discuss next topic, our shearing strength and crushing strength, by tomorrow's class. And thank you. Have a nice day.